Welcome in Engineering Materials and Metallurgy Laboratory. I am Professor A.P. Godke, Assistant Professor at Department of Mechanical Engineering of S&D College of Engineering and Research Center, Babulgaon, Yewla. Today, we are going to perform the experiment in Engineering Materials and Metallurgy Laboratory. Experiment number 1. The title of experiment is destructive testing, in which we are going to perform Rockwell hardness test. So this is our first experiment in Engineering Materials and Metallurgy Laboratory. Destructive testing. The aim of the experiment is to study Rockwell hardness test and determine hardness number of material. So this is our aim of experiment, to study Rockwell hardness test and determination of hardness number of material. Next, learning objective of the experiment. So from this experiment, we learn how the hardness value of any material is determined using Rockwell hardness testing machine. So our learning objective is to know how hardness of any material is determined by using Rockwell hardness testing machine. Next is apparatus, means which equipment we are going to use to conduct the experiment. So here we are going to use Rockwell hardness testing machine as a equipment to conduct the experiment. Then next is a specimen of steel. That is nothing but our workpiece or sample, that is called as a specimen, which is made up of a steel material, which is a ferrous material. Before going to perform actual experiment in laboratory, we must know the basic of Rockwell hardness test. So in that, first will be what is meant by hardness. So that is nothing but definition of hardness. So the hardness represent the resistance of material surface for impression, penetration, abrasion, scratching and cutting. Means it is the mechanical property of the material in which the resistance offered by the material surface for impression, penetration, abrasion, scratching and cutting is called as a hardness of that material. The hardness value of any material gives clear indication of the strength of that particular material. Means if hardness is more, the strength of the material is good. If hardness value is less, then directly we can say it has a strength of that particular material is less. So next part is, in this Rockwell hardness test, a defined force is mechanically applied on the workpiece and the indenters used are made up of a steel ball or diamond material with cone shape. So in Rockwell hardness test, mechanically force, that is a load, is applied on workpiece as well as through a device we can perform the penetration is called as a indenter. So two types of indenters may be used in Rockwell hardness test. One is a steel ball indenter and second one is a cone indenter or braille indenter whose tip is coated with the diamond material. Next, in Rockwell hardness tester, it presents direct reading of the hardness number on the dial provided with the machine. Means in Rockwell hardness testing, the direct reading of hardness value is obtained from the dial scale of instrument. Okay, so that is the one of the important condition or arrangement is there in the Rockwell hardness tester. So there are many scales that are having combination of loads and size of indenter, but commonly C scale is used for consideration of the hardness value, and that hardness value is represented or presented as a HRC. Means there are number of scales are used in the Rockwell hardness testing in dial depending on the type of load and indenter, size of the indenter. But most commonly used scale is a C scale, which is represented by or represented as a HRC. Here the indenter has a cone type with a diamond tip, a tip at diamond, and applied force is a 150 kgf. So in case of C scale reading, cone type of indenter used whose tip is coated with the diamond material and applied force is a 150 kg. If our sample material is a soft material which can be tested in B scale with the 1/16 inch diameter of steel ball at a 60 kg of load, means if our material is a harder sample material, then we are going to use a diamond cone indenter. And if our sample material is soft, then we are going to use a B scale reading, then 1/16 inch diameter steel ball indenter, and load will be 60 kgf. Okay, so also one of the important condition in Rockwell hardness test for specimen is the specimen surface should be flat and free from dirt, grease, oil or scale. It means that before performing the experiment, we are going to do machining operation on specimen. Means the specimen surface should be flat and it should be free from dirt, grease, oil, scale or dust particles. So that care we are going to take. Next part is the principle of Rockwell hardness test. So Rockwell hardness test is work on the principle of differential depth measurement. The depth of indentation or penetration will be more for soft material and less for hard material. Means this Rockwell hardness test depends on the depth of penetration of the indenter into the sample. So that depth of penetration is considered for calculation of the hardness value. So this is the principle of Rockwell hardness test. Next is the specification of hardness testing machine and indenters. So hardness test can be conducted on the Rockwell hardness testing machine. The specimen may be cylinder, cube, thick or thin metallic sheet type. Okay, so this is the specimen's geometry. It may be cylindrical, it may be cubic, it may be thick or thin metallic sheet. Then type of indenter, steel ball or cone type of indenter can be used whose tip is coated with the diamond material. So this is the specifications of the machine and indenters for hardness testing. Next part is the construction of Rockwell hardness testing machine. So here this is the construction diagram of Rockwell hardness testing machine in which different parts are there. So first important part is the anvil, or it is called as a work table. Second is the specimen. So on work table we have to keep our specimen. Next one is the indenter, so device through which we are going to perform penetration, so that is called as indenter. So in Rockwell hardness testing machine, either cone indenter or braille indenter are used, or either steel ball indenter is used. The next part is of the instrument is load sector. So here by using load sector we are going to select major load, which is a 60 kg or 100 kg or 150 kg depending on the sample material. Next important part is the lever to apply the load gradually. So here by using this lever we can apply the load and we can release the load. Next important part is the dial scale. So here In Rockwell hardness testing machine, two types of scales are used. One is a C scale, which gives the hardness value, and second one is a B scale, which also gives the hardness value for 60 kg load, and C scale reading gives hardness value for 150 kg load. So these are the different components present in the Rockwell hardness testing machine. So this is the construction of Rockwell hardness testing machine. Next is a three-dimensional diagrammatic representation of the Rockwell hardness testing machine. So this is the actual setup of equipment present in our laboratory to conduct the Rockwell hardness testing machine, to conduct the Rockwell hardness test by using this machine. So this is the first important part, that is nothing but anvil, or called as a work table, on which we have to keep our sample, that is called as a specimen. Then indenter, a device through which we can apply the load or we can perform the penetration. Then dial scale, B scale and C scale reading is there. Load selector knob, that is also called load sector. So from here we can adjust the major load, 60 kg, 100 kg or 150 kg. Then next part is the lever, so through which we can apply the load and we can release the load. So this is what the actual setup of the Rockwell hardness testing machine in the laboratory. Next is the procedure for the conduction of the actual experiment in the laboratory. So first step, we have to insert a ball of diameter capital D in the ball holder of indenter of the machine, or select diamond cone type of indenter as per specimen material. Means if specimen material is a harder, then we have to go with the cone indenter. If specimen material is a soft, then we are going to use ball indenter. So second step, make the specimen surface clean by removing dust, dirt, oil and grease, so that it does not affect the calculation of the hardness value. So by using cotton cloth, we can clean the specimen surface. Next step, select major load in load selector knob based on specimen material. Means in load sector, we are going to select major load value, that is nothing but 150 kg for hard material and 60 kg for soft material. Okay, so we are going to select that major load value in the load sector. Next step, we have to make contact between the specimen surface and tip of the indenter by rotating the jack adjusting wheel. Means manually we have to increase the height of the work table so that the surface of the specimen should be in contact with the tip of the indenter. So this is called as a application of the minor load, which is equal to 10 kgf. So once 10 kg of load is applied, it will be considered as a minor load. Okay, so there is a special arrangement in the dial scale. Small pointer is there, which shows the value of the minor load application. Next step, apply major load 150 kgf by using lever for loading. Means after the application of minor load, we have to apply the major load as a 150 kg by using the lever. Next, after the application of the major load by using lever, wait for 10 to 15 seconds for complete penetration. So the gradual load will apply automatically and complete penetration of indenter for selected load is done. So this is the next step. Okay, so when we apply the major load, complete penetration of the indenter for the selected load is done. We have to wait for 10 to 15 seconds. Next step, remove the load, making lever to original position back. So again, after 10 to 15 seconds, we have to release the load by changing the position of the lever to its original position. Then next step, check the reading using dial indicator scale, either B scale or C scale reading, depending on the type of the specimen. Next, note down the hardness reading of first trial using dial scale. Okay, so this is the next step. We have to note down the hardness value reading from the dial scale directly. Next, take total 5 trials for same material and note down hardness for each trial. Means simultaneously we have to take total 5 trials and note down the hardness value for each trial. After that, final step, calculate the average of all trial reading, which gives final hardness value. Means we have to take average of all 5 trial hardness values, and the final answer will be the hardness of the material. So next is the impression made on the specimen after application of the load. So this is the sample or specimen. This is the diamond cone indenter. When we apply the minor load, there will be initial penetration. So this is the application of minor load. So you can observe the penetration of the indenter into the sample. So here this black region or area shows the indentation by minor load. After that, major load we have to apply. When we apply the major load, there will be more penetration. So you can observe this region is the penetration after major load application. So here, after application of the major load, you will get this much depth penetration. So this point and this point represent the depth of penetration, which is denoted by small t. So this is depth of penetration after the application of the major load. So this is the diagrammatic representation which shows the impression made on the specimen after application of the load. Next, observations. So while conducting the experiment, following observations we have to take into consideration. So first is the specimen material. So specimen material is the steel, which is a spring steel, quite hard steel. The minor load is 10 kg up, major load is 150 kg up, scale reading B scale or C scale reading, that is a black reading. So after conducting experiment for trial 1, we will get the hardness value as a 60.8 HRC. Simultaneously or similarly for trial 2, hardness value is a 60.9 HRC. For trial 3, 61.0 HRC. For trial 4, 60.9 HRC, and for trial 5, 60.8 HRC. So the average of all the 5 trials will be equal to 60.88 HRC. Means in this way we are going to get the final value of hardness as a 60.88 HRC. Next, result. So the Rockwell hardness number for given spring steel sample is a 60.88 HRC, or Rockwell hardness number HRN, it is also called as HRN, is equal to 60.88, or HRC is equal to 60.88. Then conclusion. So from this experiment we determine hardness of steel material using Rockwell hardness testing machine. So this is the conclusion of our experiment. So from this experiment we determine the hardness of steel material using Rockwell hardness testing machine. Next is the simulation or demonstration of Rockwell hardness test. So means in virtual laboratory we can now perform the experiment for Rockwell hardness test. So the objective of Rockwell hardness test to find the Rockwell hardness number of mild steel or cast iron or brass or aluminum and spring steel, etc. So the apparatus used is the Rockwell hardness testing machine. So here is the simulation mode of the experiment where we can perform the experiment in virtual laboratory. So here you can observe the setup for Rockwell hardness testing machine. So this is the operator who can perform the experiment here. So step number one in virtual experiment, select the specimen of your choice. So different sample materials are given or specimens are given, like this is cast iron, this is mild steel, this is a spring steel, this is a brass, and this is a aluminum. So we are going to select any one material from this given samples. So first is the cast iron. So when we are selecting the material, it will show the which type of indenter we are going to use. So for cast iron, ball indenter is used. For mild steel, type of indenter used is the ball indenter. For spring steel, type of indenter used is cone indenter. It is also called as a braille indenter, whose tip is coated with the diamond material. Next is a brass material, for which ball indenter is used. For aluminum, again ball indenter is used. Means depending on the sample material, we have to select the type of indenter. If soft material is there, just like a mild steel or aluminum, then we are going to use ball indenter. If spring steel, which is a hard material, for that we are going to use cone or braille indenter. So here we are going to perform the experiment by using the spring steel as a sample material. So next, so this is the setup for Rockwell hardness testing machine. So here we are going to apply minor load as a 10 kg. So you can observe that, so here minor load of 10 kg is applied. Okay, so here this is step number 2. The hand wheel is turned until the specimen is in contact with the indenter, and the pointer of the small dial gauge reaches the red dot, so that the minor load of 10 kg is applied. So this is trial number 1. So here equipment setup is there, then dial scale is there. So here when we click here, or by using manual loading, 10 kg minor load is applied and the small pointer reaches to the red dot. It means the minor load of 10 kg is applied. So this is the step number 2, where we are going to apply the minor load. So you can observe two types of scales are there. One is a C scale, C0, C10, C20. So this is a C scale reading, and another reading starts from B0, B10, B20 up to B90. So this is a B scale reading. Means if soft metal is there, then you have to note down this inner side reading for the hardness value. If hard material is there, then we are going to use this outer side reading as a C scale for note down the hardness value. Then this is a big pointer, which represents the hardness value. Now here big pointer is at C0, means here hardness value now it is a 0, as we are not going to yet applied major load. Upon major load, we have not applied major load yet. So the hardness is now 0. So go for next step, application of the major load. So in previous step we apply the minor load, in this step we are going to apply the major load. So here load selector knob is provided, then here display unit is there for major load observation. So here by using load selector knob, when we click on load selector knob, we can select the major load as a 150 kg for spring steel material. So here you can see the 150 kg load is now set. Now by using handle, it is at unloading condition or original position. So here it shows apply the major load. So when we click on this lever, it will change its position and 150 kg load is applied. So here you can observe 150 kg load now applied, the big pointer moving in the dial. Okay, so here after that we have to unload by changing the position of lever from position 2 to position 1, means back to original position. So here when we click on the lever and it will pull back to its original position, the final position of the big pointer shows the hardness value, and we have to note down the C scale reading. So here the Rockwell hardness number is 76. So the final position of the big pointer is at 76. So from C0 to C60, C70, C75 and C76. So this is the first trial which gives the hardness value for Rockwell hardness testing machine is 76. Similarly, we have to perform second trial to get the correct or average Rockwell hardness number. So here in first trial, sample material is spring steel, total load is 150 kg, that is major load, scale used is the C scale, and Rockwell hardness number we get as a 76. For this is the observation for trial number 1. Now trial number 2, here you can observe the small pointer is at 0, means we have to apply the minor load first. So when we move the mouse cursor on the wheel to adjust the specimen height, the small pointer reaches to the red mark, so that minor load will be applied. So you can observe small pointer reaches to the red dot and minor load of 10 kg is applied. Next step, select the major load. So here you can observe major load 150 kg or kg is selected. Then apply the load gradually by using the lever for 15 to 20 seconds. Load is applied here. Now release the load by changing the position of lever back to original position. The final position of the big pointer shows the hardness value of the material. So here you can observe C reading, C scale reading as 60, 65, 66, 67, 68.6. So this is the Rockwell hardness number for second trial as 68.6. Next is the average of both the trial reading. So here you can observe material is a spring steel, major load is a 150 kg for both trial, scale used is the C scale for both trial, and hardness number for trial 1 was 76 and hardness number for trial 2 was 68.6. so the average Rockwell hardness number for spring steel sample is a 72.30. So in this way, in simulation mode, we can get the hardness value of any material by using Rockwell hardness testing machine. Conclusion of simulation mode. From the simulation mode, we learn how experiment is performed to determine hardness of material using Rockwell hardness testing machine. Next, actual experiment conduction laboratory. So now we will see how the hardness value of the material is find out by using the Rockwell hardness testing machine in laboratory.
Welcome in metallurgy lab. Today we are going to conduct the experiment. On Rockwell hardness testing machine. The objective of this machine is to determine the hardness of ferrous materials. So we will see the different components of the instrument. So first important component is a work table. The use of the work table, we have to keep the sample on the work table. So this is the first part of the instrument, work table. Second part is a handle. So by using this handle, we can increase or decrease the height of the work table. Then second important part of the instrument is an indenter. So indenter, it is a device through which we can perform the penetration or load is applied. So two types of indenters are used in the Rockwell hardness testing machine. One is a ball indenter and second one is a braille indenter, whose tip is coated with a diamond material. Next part is a lever of the instrument through which we can apply the major load. So in Rockwell hardness testing, the major load may be 60 kg, 100 kg and 150 kg. So to apply that major load, we are having a one arrangement, that is a load selector. So here 60 kg of, 100 kg of and 150 kg of load can be selected as a major load. Next, minor load we can apply by increasing the height of the work table. So the minor load 10 kg will be applied and it can be indicated by a red dot present in the scale. Next, we are having a dial reading scale. So in this we will get the hardness value of the material. So two types of scales are there present in the dial scale. One is a red scale, that is called as a B scale, and second one is a black reading, which is called as a C scale reading. Okay. Next, you will see the small pointer which show the application of the load. Okay. So we will conduct the now actual experiment on the instrument. So we are taking the sample which is made up of a steel material whose hardness we are going to measure. So the procedure is, we have to clean the sample surface as well as the work table, and after that we are keeping the sample on the work table. Then one of the important condition of the instrument is, depending on the type of the sample, you have to select the major load and you have to select the type of indenters. So here one chart is provided for, depending on the type of the sample material, we have to select the type of indenter, we have to select the major load value, and we have to select the which type of reading, either B scale reading or C scale reading, we are going to consider. So here you will observe, for steel material you have to select the diamond, braille indenter, 150 major load, and black, that is a C scale reading, you are going to measure for checking the hardness value of the material. So here you can see 150 kg load is set. Here 150 kg of load is set in the load selector. Then lever is at position 1. So when load is applied, it will be at position 2. Now it is a no loading conditions. Okay. So initially sample is kept on the work table. We have to apply the major load. So here you can see, here no minor load. Initially we have to apply the minor load. So here 0 reading shows for the minor load. So manually, whenever we are increasing the height of the work table, the minor load will be applied, which is equal to 10 kg. Initially we have to apply the minor load manually. By increasing the height of the work table, we are going to apply the minor load. So here you can see the change in the small pointer. So up to that red dot, we have to apply the minor load, which is equal to 10 kg. So we have to increase the height of the work table. So beyond that, we have not going to increase the height of the work table, because indication is given. So dial indication may get damaged. So we have to stop the increasing the height of the work table as small pointer reaches to the red dot. So wait for some time. So the use of the minor load is to start the initial penetration of the instrument. After that, we are going to apply the major load by using the lever. So by changing the position of the lever 1 to 2, we can apply the major load. Okay. So we are changing the position. So we will get the change in the position of the big pointer in the dial indicator once load is applied. So here we apply the load by changing the lever position from position 1 to 2. So here 150 kg of load is applied. Then wait for 10 to 15 seconds for a complete penetration of the indenter into the sample. After that, we have to release the load by changing the position of the lever from position 2 to 1. Then once we release the load, the final position of the big pointer shows the hardness value of the material. Now, as our sample is made up of the steel material, we are selecting diamond as an indenter and load as our 50 kg. So, black reading we are going to check in the dial scale. Now, I am going to release the load by changing the position of lever from 2 to 1. So, you will get the result for the hardness value of the material. So here you can observe the hardness value of the material is 65 RC. So this is the first reading of hardness value for the given sample. Now decrease the height of the work table and the sample will be ready for the next trial. So
next is a conclusion of experiment number conducted in the laboratory. So from this experiment we determine the hardness number of steel material using Rockwell hardness testing machine. So in this way, in actual laboratory we perform the experiment on steel material and we determine the hardness number by using Rockwell hardness testing machine. Thank you for watching the experiment on Rockwell hardness test.